What's good, y'all? This your boy Black G92. Now for tonight, I'm going to do a reaction to this video made by Ring the Bell, titled "Everything That Happened in 2008 WWE Women's Division." Shout out to the person who gave me this video to react to. So I'm gonna see what this little overview of 2008's Women's Division and WWE in about 3, 2, 1. See what if I seen familiar faces and all that good shit.
From the debut of some of the biggest name in the WWE Women's history to the legendary I Quit match and the introduction of the Divas Championship. Okay. This is everything that happened in 2008 WWE Women's.
Man, I forgot dude's name, but like he got a pretty cool shirt, periodic table on the women's division. That's a pretty cool shirt he got there. Shit, whoever designed it did a good job on it.
Welcome to Drink Bell. This is DS, and who said 2015 is when Women's Evolution started? Because today we're going to talk about everything that happened in 2008 WWE Women's Division. And this is a really interesting year because we've seen the debut of some of the biggest name in the women's wrestling history. Okay. We've also seen some of the rising stars take that spotlight. You know, WWE likes to tell the story of how Women's Division died when Trish and Lita retired, but the fire is here, the talent is here, and the matches were there too. So we're going to talk all about the amazing things that happened in this year. So let's start with Raw first.
I am the Glamazon, the most beautiful and talented diva to ever step foot in this ring.
2008 starts with the Glamazon. As the WWE Women's Champion, she's got the iron grip on the throne. And her main rival at the...
Is it Ramazon or... Let me rewind it, because he said something about Amazon or some shit.
The Glamazon. WWE Women's Champion, she's got
she
the iron grip
name.
On
got
the
got
throne.
The
and her main rival at this time was Mickie James, even though Glamazon continues to beat her week after week. Which resulted in Mickie James being very, very frustrated.
I feel like I can't beat her. I don't know what to choose.
Oh, Mickie, you're so sad. But women...
Now, I bet, must be frustrating getting beat up by the same person after each match and during each match. Gotta be frustrating for sure. But have you seen them arms on that woman? Like, Glamazon got them pythons low-key. They just break your neck if she wanted to.
Championship who? Because it's time for the Playboy push. The early 2008's main storyline revolves around the Playboy cover, not the Women's Championship. And we see the former Playboy cover girl and the Diva Search winner Ashley Massaro return to WWE to compete in a long-way Hello Fight Fatal 5-Way match. Her brief hiatus was to compete in The Survivor, by the way. At Royal Rumble, Ashley lets Maria Kanellis know that Hugh Hefner wants Maria to pose for Playboy.
Do you guys really want
Maria's
then on-screen boyfriend Santino Marella quickly interrupts Ashley to show his disapproval of this idea.
The answer is no!
Hey, sometimes you gotta let your woman know that you ain't down with certain shit. Hey, I don't blame her for doing that. And shit. Hey, I forgot that the old girl, not the one that you just showed, the one that was shown that had the boyfriend tell her no, whatever. Like the other one that was like the former Playboy bunny, whatever. Get into the old wrestling thing, like, hey, they be traveling though. Shit, I forgot them Playboy buns be traveling. They be going to all type of places aside from being on cover of Playboy now. Shit, hats off to them though.
Rest of a segment ends with Ashley beating this oily naked dancer with cocks. And no way out, we see Maria Kanellis attend the Playboy party to ask Hugh Hefner if she'd be a good fit for Playboy. And on Raw,
so what do you want? You're gonna get
Santino make an ultimatum saying that she needs to beat Beth Phoenix to pose for Playboy. By the way, Beth looked amazing this time.
She definitely
did. Pop quiz. Who comes out to help Maria Kanellis pose for Playboy here?
No.
And the answer is Go Daddy, Candice Michelle.
Okay.
Yes, during this match, another formal Playboy cover girl, Candice Michelle, returns to distract Beth and help Maria pose for Playboy. And this sets up the Bunny Mania tag team match with Snoop Dogg as the master of ceremonies at WrestleMania.
Of course. Well, it wouldn't be a Bunny Mania without Snoop Dogg, because he's, like I said, knowing his subject matter and his songs, whatever, it wouldn't surprise me if he was do some shit like that, be the host of an event like this. Because Playboy Bunny's are right up his alley anyway, so it wouldn't surprise me. Only
Steve. This feud continues with Santino trying to sabotage Maria's Playboy cover reveal, but what was really sabotaged was Candace's big WrestleMania return because she re-injures her left collarbone in her first match back. Ashley then fills in for Candace to make sure that everything goes smoothly at WrestleMania, but during the match at WrestleMania, lights go off for almost half of the match, and poor Maria not only loses the match, but she makes out with Sasha Banks' cousin.
Typical Playboy cover girl.
But there's a silver lining for Maria because she defeats Santino in Anything Goes match as the Divas come out to beat up the misogynist.
WWE Divas should not even be competing. They should be at home.
Though they should really detect him more to prevent that.
That's kind of fucked up. Hey, no wonder they whooped his ass, because, you know, he was kind of pushing it. Right then, they're talking about this stay at home. Like, well, damn, nigga. What are you talking? This is a Stone Age Prince storyline. Yeah, I like how old dude, that little whole shit said, like, beat up the misogynist. That's funny, because he was kind of being, he was kind of pushing it for sure. Because, what you call it, like, that, his, I forgot what dude's name, that guy's ass whooped. He was definitely pushing it, though.
WrestleMania shit from happening.
My name is Santino!
Speaking of Playboy cover girls, we saw formal Playboy cover girls retire in 2008. Who are they?
Interesting. I would not guess that that whole Playboy thing was a big deal in there.
Yes, this is a crime!
And the answer is Tori Wilson and Ashley Masson. Okay. So now the Hall of Famer Tori Wilson was released from WWE contract in May of 2008 after suffering from the back injury, and then she subsequently announced her retirement. And Ashley Massaro was released in July as she asked the company to be released because she wanted to take care of her daughter who was sick at the time. Right. Now, unfortunately, the Playboy push quickly ends when Bethany squashes Maria at the start of April, and Mickie James is back in the spotlight. And here, Mickie James picks up a surprise win from Beth Phoenix, taking the WWE Women's Championship in London. Oh, the emotion.
I knew I could beat her quick! She stole a kiss from that dude.
The first time the WWE Women's title changed hands in a televised match overseas. But fun fact, Mickie James, I guess, loves Europe because in 2007, Mickie James picked up a random championship win in Paris. Wow. A week after, babyface divas of all three brands throw Mickie a big celebration.
Everyone said she was unstoppable, but last week, I proved everyone wrong.
And Beth comes out with the fellow heel divas to confront her.
Listening to this pathetic love fest prompted us to come out here and break up your little party.
And here, Michelle McCool interrupts out of nowhere.
This is a slap in the face.
Boom!
Really sticking up for Mickie.
That hurt.
Character development a little bit in the SmackDown section, but here, she comes off real strong. After this confrontation, Team Mickie James faces Team Beth Phoenix in a 12 Diva Tag Team match, where Beth Phoenix picks up the win, pinning Ashley Massaro. But this win eventually doesn't really mean much because Mickie James win the rematch the night after Backlash by pinning Jillian Hall on Raw. Beth then has the WWE Women's Championship match against Mickie James in a Lumberjill match, but Beth loses to Mickie after Melina accidentally hits Beth with her boot. This jumpstarts the legendary feud between Beth Phoenix the Glamazon and Melina. Beth gets petty and leaves Melina during a tag match, and then the two get in a crazy backstage fight.
I know that had to hurt.
This is probably my favorite one since Trish and Lita's right before WrestleMania 18. This was great. And with Mickie James as a third wheel, Melina and Beth Phoenix compete in a triple threat women's championship match at Judgment Day.
Take some damage.
Here we see the intense double backbreaker spot from Beth, but Mickie ultimately wins by pinning Melina. Beth and Melina's feud continue until One Night Stand where the two compete in a legendary I Quit match. Damn, this match was so, so good. Beth defeats Melina in this match, but their feud continues with Melina showing one of the best transitions from heel to babyface, the emotion she showed.
Is that a tag? I guess that's all Melina wanted was to get her hands
But the feud, however, is cut short as Melina injures her ankle during a tag match against Natalya and Victoria. So what happens to the women's champion, Mickie James? Since basically ending the storyline with Beth by defeating her in a non-title match, she doesn't do much for a while. Poor Mickie lives in the spotlight even as a champion. But she does keep herself busy involving herself with John Cena in a romance storyline where things get pretty sexy.
Okay.
No way!
Well, he got some brawls. Okay.
But this angle gets randomly dropped. But no time to cry over romance. Mickie James gets into a storyline with the newcomer Katie Lee Burchill. Katie Lee shocks the WWE Universe in more than one way.
If John Cena came out with me and my brother, he'd be having a lot more than just a little fun.
As her in-ring debut is in an intergender action, she teams her with her brother.
Knowing how famous John Cena was back in them days, 2008, I believe, yeah, because he was quite a big deal back then. I'm quite sure it was quite a lot more than just a little fun now. I mean, linked up with that type of guy, with that fame, and being famous as she was in her lane, yeah. Quite sure. There's some extras.
She in matches against men and win them. She then moves her interest from her brother to the championship. After pinning Mickie James multiple times, she challenges Mickie James at Night of Champions, where Mickie successfully defends her title. Their feud continues as Katie Lee attacks Mickie in front of Mickie's father in the audience, and Mickie, who's suddenly not dating John Cena anymore, looks for a new male partner to even out the Burchill couple. Wait, siblings. The Burchill siblings. So here's a quiz.
Damn.
Is Mickie James' new male partner?
Who is it?
It is a WWE Intercontinental Champion, Kofi Kingston. This feud between the two teams eventually wraps up as Mickie defeats Katie Lee in another women's championship match, but there was another power couple waiting for the cup of Kofi and Mickie. It's a newly partner up Beth Phoenix and Santino Marella. So how did this romance start? The start of Glamorella is when Beth Phoenix defeated Santino in his open challenge. Beth then sets her eyes on Santino until they kiss. Kiss again.
Damn, she just stole that one.
And then the challenge of the games of Kofi Kingston for an intergender winner-takes-all tag team match for the Women's Championship and Intercontinental Championship at SummerSlam. And at SummerSlam, Beth picks up the win for both her and Santino with the huge Glam Slam. Ooh. Are the Glamorella happily ever after? Well, kind of. But they do have turbulences like any other couple. For example, Beth beats up Santino after she loses to Kelly Kelly due to his distraction. She was also bleeding from this match. But Beth's love for Santino is made clear when she takes Batista's spine buster for standing up for her man. And Santino also continues to love Beth Phoenix even after that awkward attack on a dude from Jackass. Back to the championship tour. Candice Michelle returns from the injury and defeats the champion in a tag match with a roll-up. My favorite interaction between the two is when Beth Phoenix awkwardly just like follows Candice Michelle during her entrance. So bizarre. Beth Phoenix ultimately defeats Candice Michelle with the Glam Slam at No Mercy, wrapping up this storyline. Or Candy wrapping up this storyline. Here's the weird thing about 2008.
Hey, all these like interesting storylines as such. Ooh, it's kind of hard to keep up with all of them. Shit, it's hard to kind of focus on one or the two that just passed. But man, I had no idea that they were going this strong back in that. Has it been 13, 14 years ago?
And Jamie Noble got highly involved with several divas throughout
the
week. Wickedly Brawl's power couple.
He tries for weeks to win Layla's heart, but Layla chooses William Regal instead of Jamie.
And yes, then she was going
off for weeks. Then Mickie James somehow feels really sympathetic and tries to help Jamie Noble pick up the win from Burchill siblings, but then they lose to Glamorella again. And then they were supposed to face William Regal and Layla, like that makes the storyline sense. But what happens is at Cyber Sunday, they didn't get enough votes, so they couldn't have the match in the pay-per-view. Yeah, so the year has been kind of hit and miss with Mickie James, but she did prove that the crowd is still in love. No, obsessed for Mickie James by winning the Halloween costume contest 2 years in a row. After beating Candice Michelle, Beth Phoenix defeats Mickie James in the Women's Championship. She also defeats 2008 Hall of Famer Mae Young in a 16-woman tag match. In the Survivor Series, Beth Phoenix leads the Team Raw to victory when she became the sole survivor. Although, I have to say, the MVP of this match is probably Maryse, and we're going to talk about her, the rise of Maryse in the SmackDown section. After Survivor Series, Melina comes back with the whole new fashion, losing the fur boots. This starts her feud with Beth Phoenix, but this time Melina as a full-fledged babyface. She even gets into a split battle with Santino Marella.
Ooh, I know that hurt. Man, Melina killed that split. She got
the
moves.
When Diva of the Year Slammy Ghost Beth Melina attacks her. In the last Raw episode of the year, we see Melina right become the number one contender winning the Divas Battle Royale. So here's the quiz. When Melina made her return to WWE, this Diva debuts that night. Who would it be?
Man, she definitely got some moves right there. Oh my, taking that one on.
2,000 miles away.
The answer is Rosa Mendez. Rosa debuts as a super fan of Beth Phoenix, and we see them interact more and more as week pass by.
Talk about epic matchups.
Now, let's not forget about one diva that was really growing in 2008, and that is Kelly Kelly. She's been slowly being pushed on Raw throughout the year as she picks up big wins after big wins, and we also see her getting involved with brief angles with likes of Batista and Klein. And at the end of the year, we see Kane abduct Kelly Kelly after presenting the couple's awards together at Slammy, but this weird love storyline does have silver lining. When Kelly Kelly abruptly leaves one Raw episode where she was supposed to tag with John Cena, Cena surprises everyone by bringing in... Trish Stratus to fill in for Kelly Kelly in the main event of Raw. This was in Trish's hometown, Toronto, the same arena she retired 2 years before. By the way, if you're enjoying this video, you might also like this t-shirt. WWE Women's Division periodic table, so we have everyone from Mae Young to Bianca Belair, EST. If you can really name everyone in this periodic table, you are definitely the master of WWE Women's history.
Yeah, so check it out and she's screamed down below.
Alright, so that was Raw, and let's move to SmackDown. We begin the year with the most divas being part of men's storyline. Cherry is managing Deuce and Domino. Maurice comes back flirting with Teddy Long.
Well, how do I look?
And Michelle McCool is in a three-way relationship with Chuck Alright, so that was Raw, and let's move to SmackDown. We begin the year with the most divas being part of men's storyline. Cherry is managing Deuce and Domino. Maurice comes back flirting with Teddy Long.
Well,
how do I look?
Michelle McCool is in a three-way relationship with Chuck Palumbo and Jamie Noble. But yeah, this three-way storyline is a mess. She gets even taken out with the stretcher.
Despicable is a word that comes to my mind.
But she does show a lot of promise in the ring, debuting the new finisher, Wings of Love. Michelle McCool eventually gets rid of both men in her life. Or more like they leave her be when the storyline fizzles out after Chuck ultimately defeats Jamie Noble and Jamie Noble dumps Michelle McCool.
I don't blame her.
Let you off the hook and Jamie Noble to recast Michelle.
WB starts this weird 4-week contest to find the top diva of SmackDown with Eve Torres, Cherry, Maurice, Victoria, and Michelle McCool as a competitor. After the swimsuit contest, boot camp, arm wrestling, and wet and wild water match, Maurice, Victoria, Eve Torres are eliminated from the audience votes. And in the finals, Michelle McCool win the contest. So here's a quiz. Congrats. What did Michelle McCool win for winning this contest?
I like to know this as well.
The answer is a motorcycle. So she never forgets about all those beautiful days cycling around with Chuck Palumbo, her ex. This win prompts Victoria,
the number one diva on SmackDown,
to bring out the debuting Natalya to attack both Michelle and Cherry.
Ring of Honor!
Damn, what a secret weapon.
She does debut with her now signature blonde hair, but she later dyes it red, allegedly to differentiate herself from Beth Phoenix.
Okay, well, gotta do what you can do.
Yeah, baby.
make yourself stand out.
The heels of SmackDown, Victoria, Natty, and Maurice then feud with Cherry and Michelle. And in this process, Maurice gets Deuce and Domino to dump Cherry and replace her as a new manager of the team.
Cool.
And we see Cherry and Maurice feud for a bit where there isn't a decisive winner. In June, SmackDown General Manager Vicky Guerrero announces the introduction of Divas Championship, and we get two Golden Dream matches to decide the two challengers for the title. And Natalya and Michelle McCool win the matches to set up the first Divas Championship match. Hmm. And at the Great American Bash,
so that's when it was set up, the first Divas match. That's when it was first set up. Back in 2008, forgot what they mentioned, but... That's dope.
Who wins a WWE Divas Champion, becoming the historic first ever champion for the
title.
In the meantime, the GM, Vicky Guerrero, is busy preparing for her wedding, and she brings in Alicia Fox as the wedding planner.
This is Alicia Fox. She's our wedding planner.
But here's a quiz. Which SmackDown diva catches the bouquet that Vicky throws? The answer is Cherry. During her pre-wedding celebration, Vicky throws a bouquet when Cherry catches it, and then she competes with Cherry in her last singles match in WWE as she was later released from her WWE contract in August. The wedding goes sour, by the way, when Triple H exposes Edge for cheating on Vicky with Alicia Fox. Since the crowning of the Divas champion, we see Divas action really get invigorated in SmackDown side. We have Maria Kanellis get drafted to SmackDown and the Brie Bella debut. And during this time, Maryse really starts to grow as a top heel of SmackDown, as she continues to be absolutely unbearable backstage to everyone.
You're not a diva. You're a dog. Jealousy is so ugly. You have fits. You're not going in the ring wearing this, don't you? The material looks really cheap. The construction, really sloppy.
After defeating Maria Kanellis in the match, she gets a chance to challenge Michelle McCool for the Divas Championship at Unforgiven. Maryse, however, loses to Michelle McCool at Unforgiven. And on SmackDown a couple weeks after. Maryse continued to feud with Michelle McCool, even interfering in the now infamous champion versus champion match, and helped Beth Phoenix defeat McCool. And we all remember the glam slam that happened this night. In the meantime, Brie Bella continued to defeat
the
Victoria
one they call
the
Grand Slam
with her magical power. She drops hints of what's to come.
Do you think maybe you can make me something for the ring? Could you make me an extra one exactly the same? Girl can have too many outfits.
Oh, Miss Fashion Designer.
I guess Maria's gimmick then was that she's a designer.
But you know what? We don't keep secrets around here, Brie. No secrets.
And on November 7th. After 2 months of teasing and defeating poor Victoria, Nikki Bella officially debuts from beneath the ring.
Two girls! The twins!
Now, it's finally time for Michelle I'm Loving Life McCool's heel turn. When Maria wins the Divas Las Vegas pole match to win the number one contendership match, Michelle starts to slowly show her real color. She first treats Maria like she's not a threat.
See you later.
And then gets more and more annoyed with Maria leading up to the Divas Championship match.
We're gonna talk about this right now. You've got to learn to focus. She's a good friend of mine, but she's missing a little bit upstairs, if you know what I mean.
Before their championship match, we got Survivor Series, and this was the first time we had Raw vs. SmackDown 5-on-5 elimination match with Michelle as a captain of SmackDown. In this match, Michelle gets eliminated early by Mickie James after fighting with Maryse.
Royal Rumble.
And then she eats Mickey DT, gets eliminated. The real standout from the match, as I've already told you, is Maryse. She really gives Beth Phoenix a big fight, and she becomes the sole survivor from the SmackDown side. But of course, she loses to Beth Phoenix with a glam slam. Shortly after Survivor Series on SmackDown, Maria finally gets her shot at the Divas Championship. Michelle McCool, though, defeats Maria with the ankle lock and doesn't let her go even after the bell ring. Her heel turn continues as she fights with the Bella Twins and Maria Kanellis when she loses to Maryse in a tag match. A week after, she loses to Maria in a singles match, and then she attacks Maria backstage.
Damn!
You got what you deserve.
Armageddon 2008, during an 8 Divas Santa's Little Helper match, Michelle blind tags in and pins Jillian Hall to win. Here's a quiz. What move did Michelle McCool use to win this match at Armageddon?
I didn't know this. Because Michelle stays taking L's.
You were debuting
for a minute.
Yeah, she had to change her finisher because the Wings of Love was banned, so she debuted the Facebreaker, even though we now see Mandy Rose use Wings of Love. How times have changed. SmackDown then sees a number one contendership match between Maria Kanellis and Maryse, where Maryse wins. The week after, we're treated with the Divas Championship match with the special guest referee, Maria Kanellis. Michelle warns Maria to not mess things up.
Please don't mess this one up for me. I highly advise against it.
But Maryse wins the Divas Championship from Michelle McCool anyway.
Divas champion, Maryse!
And Michelle completely loses it, brutally attacking Maria after her loss.
Oh, Well, let's go and attack your teammate after the loss.
Let's talk about ECW real quick. ECW really didn't have much going on its own, especially with the roster sharing going on. We did see the brief feud between Kelly Kelly and the team of Lena, Yada, and Layla. Here we see the best body swimsuit contest on ECW's HD debut and a dance-off, which were all won by Kelly Kelly. They also bring in SmackDown divas like Victoria and Michelle McCool to further the feud. Yeah, so this is basically the only women's feud in ECW until, like, May.
Tiffany!
Hey, Mr.
You're looking gorgeous.
In June, Tiffany makes her debut as assistant general manager under Teddy Long, and Alicia Fox moves to ECW after ruining Edge and Vicky's wedding, teaming up with DJ Gabriel. Well, there you go. That is everything that happened in 2008. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in for this video. You can find me at DS Shin and Ring the Bell DS on Twitter, and I'll see you soon. Bye!
Man, that was quite a bit to take in. Ooh, that was everything that happened in 2008. WWE Women's Division. Quite a lot has happened in that year that I had no idea about. Quite a bit of different crazy-ass storylines, relationships, like, lost it, wins and losses. Especially with certain people there, like Michelle State taking L's. But she definitely got some dubs in there. Maurice was just in there just killing shit, though. Hats off to her. And also, like, I gotta say this, like, okay, Glamazon, man. Whew, she's one tough one. I can tell she's one tough woman right there. Ooh, especially with those arms. I'm just so impressed with those arms, man. Like, shit. That got me wanting to get back in the gym. Shit. Like I said before, man. And also, I also got to mention something else about the whole Playboy thing. I had no idea Playboy was a big deal in WWE Women's Division. I had no idea it was that big of a deal. But, hey. Those are the times we're in. And plus, I'm quite sure the cameo Hugh Hefner didn't age well. Hence, you know, all the docuseries came out exposing all the dirt he allegedly done, whatever. But I'm not going to get into that. It's because this video is already way too long anyway. So I'm going to go ahead and just sign out real quick. Be sure to follow me on social media accounts, which is posted in the description box below. It's your first time watching this reaction video. Be sure to hit that like button, hit that notification button, hit that subscribe button. And also be sure to hit me up whatever it is, like reaction requests you want, movies, not like movie clips, trailers, any other WWE like countdowns, analysis videos, songs, music videos. And also, like, interviews, anything related to politics. Be sure to post up in the comment section below. It's your boy, Black G92. About to sign off. I'll let your boy. Peace.